If you have trouble sleeping, or if you seem to sleep fine but you don't feel rested and energetic during the day, then this video is for you. It could be that the solution to your problems is as simple as glycine. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and you're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is detail schmetails, just tell me what works. And one thing that can work for better sleep is 3 grams of glycine before bed. Now, there's a few ways to do this, but first let's talk about why it works. Studies have shown that not only does glycine have a calming effect in the brain to help you wind down and prepare for sleep, but also it helps lower your core body temperature at night, which is one of the things that makes your sleep more effective. When you fall asleep, you get into slow wave sleep quicker and you stay stable in that state. And so what happens is not only might you get more sleep, but your sleep might be more restful so that even though glycine itself has a calming effect, you may feel more energized during the day. The studies that have been done have used 3 grams of glycine. There are a couple ways to get that. One is to just buy a glycine supplement. I don't care which one you use really, but take the glycine supplement in the amount that provides 3 grams of glycine right before bed. Another way to do that, and one that I frequently advocate as a way of getting glycine, is to take collagen. Hydrolyzed collagen, such as Great Lakes or Vital Proteins, one serving generally provides a little over 3 grams of glycine. Just make sure you look at the nutrition facts to make sure that that's what you're getting. Now, should you do one or the other? Well, you really have to try it. So I have some clients who report that they get gastrointestinal distress when they take free glycine, but not when they take hydrolyzed collagen. I have another client who takes free glycine because he gets GI distress from taking hydrolyzed collagen and not free glycine. I have another client who doesn't get GI distress from either of these supplements, but collagen doesn't help her sleep, and it looks like free glycine does. Why might that be the case? Well, one of the reasons that glycine promotes a calming effect in the brain is that it antagonizes the excitatory effects of another amino acid, glutamate. If you're taking hydrolyzed collagen, you're getting some glutamate in it, and so the glycine might not be as effective for you if messing with that ratio is really what you need. Additionally, it might be the case that just taking the glycine on its own helps the glycine get better into the brain when there aren't as many competing amino acids. So that might be one reason that you need to try free glycine. And if collagen doesn't work for you, don't rule out that free glycine might be the answer. On the other hand, my best friend says that she needs about 20 grams of glycine. And in order to get that amount of glycine, she needs to rely on collagen. And if she takes it as free glycine, she feels super out of it, out of breath, and like she's dying. So the point is everyone's a little bit different. Start slow with 3 grams. Don't use higher until you know you need it. I'll talk about how to know that in the next video, in 2 videos from now. Start slow with 3 grams. Make sure that you try free glycine and you try collagen. Pick the one that works the best with the least GI distress, if that's an issue, and the best results that makes you feel the best, sleep the best, and feel the most rested and energized when you wake up. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. You've been watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next video.